Hey guys, Tech Timmy here, coming at you with another gripping unboxing video. Today we are going to be unboxing the Seagate One Touch with hub, and I'm curious to see what the hub looks like. It's an external hard drive. I went with the 4 terabyte model. I'm gonna take it out of the box right now. Let's go.
Oh boy, it's Tech Timmy time.
All right, so I bought my first ever gaming PC, and it arrives Monday, which is the day of tomorrow. So I figured I want to back up my existing PC and all my laptops. So I'm gonna get all my files off there and do it in a very sort of orderly, organized fashion. And I think what I really like about this is I can keep the files on here, most of them, and pull the ones that I need when I need them, which is great. So that's gonna free up a whole bunch of space right off the bat. I think my new PC has actually also comes with a 4 terabyte hard drive. So between this and the other, this 8 terabytes, I think I have another 2 terabytes on my laptop. So I should have plenty of storage to last me quite a while. So again, I went with a 4 terabyte model. This is an external hard drive. It has both USB-C and USB 3.0. It comes with some backup software. I'm not gonna need that. I probably won't use it, I don't think. And then Dropbox as well. I really don't like those cloud storage solutions, mostly because it takes too long to get the files up and down. So I work with a lot of large video files and small video files, and it just takes forever to be able to upload them and download them to and fro the cloud. I like the idea of having most of my storage locally. There are definitely some practical applications for cloud storage, but I'm really excited about getting this into my setup here. And so this video is part of my computer upgrade series. I have a whole bunch of videos lately where I'm basically going and updating both my computer setup and my desk setup, and then also my creator setup for recording video. So, all right, without further ado, let's get this out of the box. Seagate does a nice job with the packaging, and not a real lot of information on the box. There's a whole bunch of languages on the back. I'll show you in a second. And then so here we have multiple different languages, as you can see, all the way down here. So we have English, French, Spanish, Netherlands. Wow, there's a whole bunch of languages here. So one of the benefits of this is it comes with, as I had said, easy backup and intelligent USB Type-C and USB 3.0 ports to manage and charge your devices. So I believe with the charging, there's sort of a pass-through deal there where if you want to charge right out of the drive, you can, which is cool. And then, so desktop served with password protection. So you can actually assign a password to this. I probably won't. It's basically, I'm a one-man show here, but I guess if my crib was ever broken into and my data was stolen, I guess that would give me some additional peace of mind. So I'm gonna think about that. And then back up your computer with included software. Again, I probably won't go there. I'm hoping that we can just connect this and we'll be plug and play. Just get right out of the box here. And if anything runs long or if I have trouble getting anything out of here, I will fast forward through those parts of the video. So there is that. So, okay, so it looks like it wants us to pull the box out here. It's in there, nice and snug. Real snug, actually, for these unboxing videos. So, okay, so that is everything in the box. And again, Seagate, you know, reputable company, been in the backup game forever, since I was a kid, actually. So, you know, I feel like that this is the exact right thing for what I need here. Okay, so this is the storage device itself. It's light. It's actually lighter than I was expecting for some reason. So I'm not sure why I was expecting it to be heavy. But it feels solid for sure. But it has kind of a little bit of a plasticky feel to it. You know, not as solid state as I was expecting, as I guess I said that already. So here is our power, and then we have some sort of a port there. I'm not sure what that is. Then we have our USB Type-C and USB, regular USB 3.0 there. So, okay, so good looking device. Definitely a good looking device. And this is gonna look nice as part of my desk setup. In fact, I think I might actually put this on the same shelf as my new PC. So that way I can just kind of keep it there and transfer files back and forth. We have a little bit of documentation here. Well, let's just take a quick look at that for sake of completeness. Seagate One Touch with hub. Okay, quick start guide, blah, blah, blah. And then, okay, so seems very straightforward. So basically you plug it in, and then I'm going to go USB-C, I believe it's, let's see, micro USB-C ports require a micro B to USB-C cable, not included. All right, so that's kind of a little chintz. Okay, so I'm not loving that they couldn't spare the cable, but it is what it is. Let's take a closer look here. I don't even know if I have a USB-C to micro B USB. Is it C to C? Let me see. Let's just take a closer look here. All right, so we've got our drive out. Now, what's in the other box here? Let's just scope this out. Surprised they don't provide the actual cables. Looks like they provide several international style plugs and for all manner of outlets, which is fine, and I guess could come in handy for some, but again, the fact that they don't have the right cable for USB-C connector is a little weak, I think. All right, so here we have this plug here, and I believe, so it says push down, oh. So this must be just protective cover. That's all that is, okay. And then here is where we need to make sure that we get our right plug for the good old US of A here. So they sent more international plugs than you can shake a stick at here. This is the most adapters for power that I've ever seen in any device. And I've done a lot of these unboxing videos, guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And it looks like this one, the one with the two little holes in it, is the one for the good old US of A's. So I'm going to insert that one. And as you can see, there's a little divot here. If you stick it in the divot and just slide it right back, it should snap into place just like that. So that's our power outlet. It looks like we do have ample cord here. So I'm going to stick this guy. And so it looks familiar, right? So this is our good old US of A plug. I'm gonna stick that into the outlet over here. Hopefully I don't get electrocuted. Hopefully I have the right one. Here we go, so there's that. Okay, so now I'm gonna take this, the other end of the power cord, and I'm gonna put it into the power socket right back here. There we go. Okay, so that goes in there. And so they do include a cord in the USB. Okay, so no. So this is, I don't know what this is called. So I'm gonna do some research and flash it up on screen, whatever that connector is. But so this is a way that you can connect up to your computer via USB-A. So in fact, let's do that right now. I have my laptop right here, standing by here. Let me just pull that into the shot. And what I am going to do is I'm going to connect this end and just try this cord here. So this is probably not as fast as USB, but again, I don't know. So I'm not familiar with that connector. Maybe I should be. I think that could just be where my novice is coming through here. So now I have my drive connected to power. I'm also not seeing a power button. So maybe this just lights up when you connect. Let's try that right now. Okay, and I did hear a little ding. So that is somewhat encouraging. And there it is. Okay, so there's the Seagate quote unquote hub. So they basically call the external hard drive the hub. So I think that's really bad naming convention, but the external hard drive is called the hub. So that's what you want to connect into to basically, you know, transfer your files over and so forth. Jury's out in terms of whether or not that odd the cable is going to work as effectively as USB-C. I suspect probably not. I would say USB-C is probably a little faster, but I will do a little bit of additional research and leave some comments for you guys here. But just to kind of prove it out, let me see if I can adjust my camera angle here, the computer. Let me just transfer a few video files. So I have a bunch of video files in this working folder here. I'm just gonna try and drag this over to the Seagate Hub just to see how well it works direct. And if this works, I'm happy. If this gives me some funky software message, I'm not gonna be happy. So let's just see. Copying 37 items from desktop to Seagate Hub, and it's thinking, and okay, so the whole bunch of video files there. This is going much more slowly than I would expect. So that again is probably USB-C is probably gonna be faster than that, whatever that odd connector is to USB type A. So interesting. So, but I mean, the files are definitely transferring over and I'm getting them over onto my Seagate Hub without installing any additional software or you know, any other weirdness, which is exactly what I want. I basically want to be able to go direct. So this is, I think, a fine workaround, at least until I get myself a micro. So it's micro USB to USB-C. I do not have one of those cords here, so I'm going to have to buy one special just for this device. But interesting, it does seem to be working. And, you know, 4 gigabytes, I'm definitely excited to get all of my stuff backed up and all put on one centralized location, which seems to be, it's gonna be this drive. I'm just, you know, I'm a little bit confused about the different connectors and why they wouldn't provide the most important cord of all with the product itself. But like I said, I'll do some additional research. I'll flash some additional notes up on screen and so forth. But anyhow, so that is the unboxing of my Seagate One Touch with hub. The hub is actually the drive, but okay. So this is an external 4 terabyte drive that is, you know, should give me plenty of storage to back up my video files and also my iPhone. So I think I'll do a separate video on terms of how to do that. If you're interested in seeing that, drop a comment below. And yeah, if you got any value from this, you might give me a thumbs up. I'd appreciate it. Helps out the channel a lot. And sorry, I know this was a little bit scattered, but yeah, it kind of threw me for a loop a little bit, but we got 40% complete. There's a whole bunch of big video files actually being copied over right now. So not terrible, but I do want to do some additional testing with the USB Type-C. Hope to see you in the next video. Cheers.